everybody. This is Paul Wing. And Little Nipper. Ready to tell you the story of the little engine that could. Now, you ready? All aboard for the little engine that could. Once there was a little freight train called the Toyland Special. It wasn't the longest train there ever was. But I guess it was about the happiest train there ever was, because all its cars were full of nice things for boys and girls. There were cars full of toy animals, toy giraffes with long necks, teddy bears with short necks, baby giant pandas with almost no necks at all, toy cows that moved when you turned them upside down, toy lions that roared when you squeezed their stomachs. And there was a toy baby elephant. At the end of his trunk, he held a toy elephant bell that tinkled. Then there were mama dolls with blue eyes and curly yellow hair. And mama dolls with brown eyes and curly brown hair. And there was a toy clown with a flag who kept running over the top of the little freight train from one car to another, waving his flag and keeping all the other toys and dolls happy and laughing. And there were cars full of toy aeroplanes with toy aviators sitting in them. Oh, and every other kind of thing that boys and girls could possibly wish for. Now the Toyland Special was carrying all those nice things from the town of Hither, where they were all made, to the town of Yon, where all the boys and girls lived who could possibly wish for them. Between Hither and Yon, there was a very high mountain. It was about that high. And, of course, the Toyland Special had to go right over the top of the mountain. Well, one day the happy Toyland Special started out on its journey. First, very slowly. Then faster and faster. Until at last it was going full speed. Its happy wheels said lickety-split, 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 lickety-split. And the happy toy clown waved his flag and kept all the other toys and dolls laughing and laughing and laughing. Yes, the Toyland Special was about the happiest train there ever was. Now the Toyland Special was getting closer and closer to the high mountain between Hither, where the toys were all made, and Yon, where the boys and girls all lived. But all of a sudden, when the train was only a short distance from the mountain, something went wrong. Instead of chugging along happily, the little train began to slow down. Slower and slower it went, until at last it just stopped stock still. The engine of the Toyland Special had broken down. Well, the dolls and toys stopped laughing, and the clown stopped waving his flag and running backward and forward over the tops of the cars, because it certainly looked as though they would never get to Yon to give the boys and girls their toys and dolls. And they were all very discouraged. All except the clown. Suddenly, the toy clown had an idea. He said, there is more than one way of getting over the mountain from Hither to Yon. Aviators, start up the motors of your airplanes. They will pick up the train and fly it across the mountain. One by one, the toy aviators started the motors of their toy aeroplanes. And then, when they had got them all running, they made them go faster and faster. And slowly but surely, the little train began to move. And from the whole train, up went a cheer. But the Toyland Special didn't fly up into the air at all. The cheer that had gone up went down. And the moment the train began to go up the mountain, it began to slow down. And the upper it went, the downer it slowed, until at last it just stopped stock still. And they were all very discouraged. All except The clown. The clown saw that they had come to a switch where another track ran into the track the Toyland Special was on. And coming toward them, on the other track, was a shiny new engine. The clown said, aha, there are more than two ways of getting over the mountain from hither to yon. What we need is an engine to pull us over. Maybe this is the engine that could. The clown waved his flag. And the shiny new engine stopped. The clown bowed politely and said, how do you do? As you can see, our Toyland Special has broken down. We're looking for an engine to switch over onto our track and pull us over the mountain to yon. Are you the engine that could? Well, the shiny new engine didn't answer. So the clown said loudly, I'm sure you're the engine that could. The shiny new engine looked down over his cowcatcher with his headlight eye. There was a nasty sneer on the front of his big round boiler. And he said, I could. If I would. But I won't. He drew himself up to the full height of his smokestack and said, listen, I am a passenger engine. And I have just pulled a fine passenger train over the mountain with more cars than you have ever dreamed of. Sleeping cars, a dining car, and parlor cars. I pull the likes of you? I guess not. And with that, he began to huff and puff. And he started up and steamed off to the roundhouse where engines live when they're not out pulling trains. And the dolls and toys were all very discouraged. All except... The clown. The clown said, listen to me. There are more than three ways of getting over the mountain from hither to yon. And he said, every able-bodied toy will now get out and push. But the Toyland Special said, oh dear, I don't believe that will work. I don't believe it won't work, said the clown, because we haven't tried it yet. Come on, he said. So the toys and dolls all tumbled out of the little cars and began to push. And the toy elephant put his head against the very last car, and he pushed too. They pushed and pushed and pushed and pushed. And slowly the Toyland Special began to move. But it moved so slowly that at last they all stopped pushing. They could see it was no use. And they were all terribly discouraged. All except... The clown. The clown said, there are more than four ways of getting over the mountain from hither to yon. And coming toward them was a big, strong engine. And the clown said, we are looking for an engine to pull us over the mountain, and I'm sure you're the engine that could. But the big, strong engine said, I could. If I would. But I won't. I have just pulled a big, strong train over the mountain with more big, strong cars than you have ever dreamed of. And a caboose, he added. I am a very important big, strong engine indeed. I will not pull the likes of you. And waving a front wheel disdainfully at the Toyland Special, he puffed off angrily to the roundhouse. Everybody was terribly discouraged. Everybody except the clown. The clown said, listen to me. There are more than five ways of getting over the mountain from hither to yon, because I think I hear another engine coming right now. Perhaps this is the engine that could. It was a rusty old engine, wheezing and coughing as he came down the track and stopped. Please, sir, pleaded the clown, will you pull our little train over the mountain? But the rusty old engine shook his cowcatcher sadly and said, I would, if I could, but I can't. I feel terrible. I must rest my rheumatic wheels.
I cannot pull even so little a train as yours. And then he chugged off to the roundhouse, saying, I cannot, I cannot, I cannot, I cannot, I cannot, I cannot. Well, the dolls and toys were all frightfully discouraged, but not the little clown. Don't be sad, shouted the clown. There are more than six ways of getting over the mountain from hither to yon. And just at that very moment, they heard a whistle. And a little, oh, a very little bright blue engine chugged merrily up to them and stopped. Perhaps this was the engine that could. So the clown explained their trouble. My, said the little bright blue engine, I'm not very big. I've never pulled a train over the mountain, but I will if I can. And I'll try. The little bright blue engine backed into the Toyland Special and coupled onto it. And the clown said anxiously, it takes a strong engine to pull us over the mountain. Are you sure you're the kind of engine that could? As the little bright blue engine started to pull, he said, I think I can, I think I can, I think I can, I think I can, I think I can. Well, the little bright blue engine pulled the Toyland Special up the mountain, closer and closer to the top. Soon they were almost at the very top. Just a few more chugs and they'd be over the mountain. The clown was worried. He said, do you think you can make it? And the little bright blue engine said, I think I can, I think I can, I think I can, I think I can, I think I can. I thought I could, I thought I could, I thought I could, I thought I could, I thought I could. And he said it all the way down the mountain until they reached the town of Yon. And so the Toyland Special got over the mountain from hither to yon, and all the boys and girls in the town of Yon got their toys and dolls after all. And that is the story of the little engine that could. Thank you, Nipper.